dark matter. Wait, what? We're getting into mutants now? Hey guys, it's your girl Aisha K, Geek XX Chic, and we're back with another reaction to The Walking Dead World Beyond. We're now into episode 2, which is called Foothold. Okay, it's not that long, convoluted. We are coming off of the season premiere, which basically had a bit of a state of the union of things after the finale of last season. We see now that Hope is now back with her father, which is good because she went through quite a bit to get to her. And we see that Iris is now with this group of neutral folks who are sitting just outside of the Commonwealth and have a deal with them to basically stay out of their business and get left alone. We'll have to see what happens in this episode. I'm really not sure where we're going to go from here, but it was kind of a really crazy move from Iris. But I am interested to see what's going on with the other members of the crew who we didn't get a chance to see in the season premiere. So I'm about to jump into this episode, but before we do, you know the drill. If you've been here before and you like what you see, please consider hitting that subscribe button. That way you'll be notified when I do more reactions to shows just like this one. So I hope you will join the fam. All right, that out of the way, guys, let's get into episode 2 right about now.
Wait, they'll find him like this.
Yeah, that's what happens when you murder somebody without plans. Oh no, guys, I think Iris is going crazy. Girl, she cannot shoot that thing. Gonna end up shooting a soldier on accident. Dude, you have a knife. What are you waiting for? You are a brave ass man because there's no way I would have trusted her with that. Meanwhile, Hope's just chilling in fancy digs with running water and even hot water.
I do want them to know about this. Just when the time is something close to right.
Mm-hmm. She already knows. But this is where I kind of wish that Iris was there because she's better at reading people. She would see through this chick in no time. But hopefully we'll see that from Hope.
Your indiscretion saved my daughter's lives. If they hadn't left home when they did.
You're being kind.
You're being completely stupid. I just can't think that, you know, what she's got is that good, you know? She doesn't look like she knows how to throw down that hard, but I guess it's been a long ass time for you and your nerd ass. Cannot wait for Hope to read you. And Iris, although Iris just might stab me in the face because apparently that's what we're doing now.
Did you
kill with your bare hands?
Were you ever in any kind of danger? Just wish I knew if Iris and Felix were okay too.
They are. We toughened up a lot out there.
You said that a little too assuredly. You're not good at this lying thing.
Now here you are, with me, in the exact same place, without any choices at all.
Oh, I'm glad you understand.
So we just have to go along with it?
Does your dad look like the fighting type? Besides, he's got himself a nice little boo thing now. He's got other reasons to stay. Wait, so you're having issues killing the person who's already dead and not the young boy who is fully alive?
I don't think it was MGs. The CRM, they killed Ramona.
That's true.
And what? They wanted all of us just dead? Why?
Yes!
We weren't a threat.
That you know of.
They wanted Hope. You saw how far they went to take her.
Seriously, dude. They're living in Utopia while the rest of y'all were suffering. And we're like, you're not even getting allowed to go where Utopia is. You really think they wouldn't wipe out other people they don't know? Come now. Oh, hey! It's our big friend. I thought he was locked up. No. There's a whole panorama going on. You keep your own water bottle. Thanks.
You gonna tell me where we're going?
This looks like the conversational type. Nope, he just... Okay, that was just unnecessary. You could have swerved. That simple. Just a little to the right or left. Are you going to make poor Silas do hard labor just because he's a big sum of...
I dispatched them as soon as I heard. I will update you personally, Dr. Bennett.
Like you've updated me on my security detail?
Mm-hmm. He ain't stupid. Scientist!
Oh, right. Huck, you're a mole.
Right.
That's how much my daughter's safety meant to you. You sent one soldier.
that...
That's what a real parent sounds like, Psycho.
I want the rest of my family here tonight.
Look at him trying to be tough. That's cute.
She was raised behind walls. I needed her to experience and see the world as it is in order for her to understand the stakes and to see her role. And we were willing to do
that. How many times do you think she rehearsed this speech to make it try to sound like it was anything less than douchey?
It was an error in judgment. Word of advice. I wouldn't make any more.
You're excused.
Well, now you've got the reminder of your place in this society, sir. But hopefully this will make you much more open and conducive to working with Hope and Iris, to taking this cow down already. Oh, wow, you even got new fits and everything. Life is great! I do wonder if she's going to get sucked in by all of the shiny in this place. This place makes the university campus look like the ghetto. Maybe you shouldn't be writing all that down in something that can be easily confiscated and read. Oh wow, she got it tatted. That's how deep it goes for her. Oh great, he gets to be on walker cleanup duty. 10 years into the apocalypse and y'all haven't figured out better ways to deal with things. Lame. He's like, I actually went through a place like this last season. I don't want to do it again, thanks. Who are these errant ruffians? And where did this guy find hair dye? Kind of a moment are we gonna have today? Are we gonna be able to do this or? Next task, can we go home now?
TCFT, too clever for TV.
So are these like the misfits of the CRM? Do they get sent out here because they like spray painted a wall?
Housed experiments in dark matter and neutrino physics.
Dark matter? Wait, what? We're getting into mutants now?
What inside them slows their decomposition rates and feeds their appetite. We hope to one day turn off those triggers, eliminate the dead.
That's the first time they've ever actually admitted that they take longer to like decompose, because I'm like, most of these things should have been like complete dust after like 2 years. Well, real. Could have at least waved. She's like, now I want to know what's in this room because you closed the blinds. See, I would have just passed it if you hadn't. If they left this open, they deserve it.
Need some help?
Yeah.
Who are you, Junior?
I'm just looking for
I want a mop.
Don't ask, just give. You said anything she wanted.
Do you mind if I ask your name?
I do.
You said it's a pretty small place, which means you probably already know.
I'll see you around, Hope.
We're asking you to give us a chance to make this right.
No! You go!
We're just asking you to let us stay.
I mean, you haven't really made a good case for yourselves. Oh, by the way, the CRM are showing up. Too late! Really? The wind would just have to blow at that moment, huh? Oh, calm down, sweetie. What are you gonna do? Just keep killing these people till they murder you all.
So where is my dad?
Right?
But I know he really wanted.
I really wanted to be here, yeah.
I happen to know he loves you very much.
Ma'am?
It's just so many parents who feel helpless now.
Ma'am, no, you need to just step away. Don't be touching family photos and stuff like that. You ain't gonna be part of the family. You gonna burn. Iris is going to kill you to death. And I'm actually behind this kill. Oh no, they've got him doing infomercials. Oh, he's in the sunken place. It's over for him. I don't know why I'm getting the sensation that her dad's not gonna make it out of this season. I feel like they're gonna kill him. Or he's gonna die, like, trying to save his daughters.
Are you asking about your girlfriend?
Right, like, you think this girl's dumb?
I saw her stuff in your bathroom, and she called you brilliant like 89 times.
Yeah.
She's all right.
No, she's really not. This is why we need Iris. You have no reading skills. This is why Huck took you for a ride.
You and Huck took the truck, and you said that Felix could barely walk, so
no,
how
if they felt like they should move, Felix would move.
You sure there isn't something you're leaving out?
Maybe, but I can't trust you.
Whatever it is.
Especially because you're sleeping with the enemy, quite literally.
What the hell's going on?
Can't tell you. Can't trust you. Not while you're in the sunken place.
So where do the parts go?
Resort in the Cayman Islands.
Okay, smartass.
Follow me.
Does he have to sleep here too? It's gotta stink.
So when the CRM finds people out there, do they always send them here?
No.
Just the ones we're suspicious of.
We can clear out the state while the measures keep more from coming in. We can gain a foothold. That's what we're doing here.
Nope. Pretty much just cleaning up a bunch of dead bodies because nobody else in the Commonwealth wants to get their pretty hands dirty.
Wait, you're leaving?
Yeah, I don't sleep in this hovel.
But that place can change everything.
Don't know why you ask. Know someone there?
No, just...
Your lady friend, perhaps?
Curious. Look at my little boy Silas doing recon. Oh, Huck's your girlfriend, or was. I see. You got terrible taste in women. Not surprised.
This is war. Even if they don't know it yet.
Oh, it's so cute that you think so. No, you could have died this afternoon because of CRM. There's like 40 of them with guns.
Manipulation to get Hope here. It's eroded some of his enthusiasm towards the CRM. Towards all the very promising work he's doing.
And she's gonna be like, just spread your legs wider, sweetie, like we had told you to do from the get-go. Don't try to grow a conscience now. So she's testing on live people. Got it. Okay, guys, that was episode 2 of season 2. And I mean, some of my predictions seem to be coming true. It looks like we'll see what happens. It might be too early to say, I should say. But I can definitely see where there could be a real seduction model for Hope the more she spends time here. Not so much because she trusts the CRM, but because of all the opportunity it presents. We saw how intrigued she got in her dad's research and how excited she got about the kind of stuff that they're working on there. And there's nothing wrong with that because if you are someone where that's your jam, of course you're gonna geek out a little bit. But I'm just a little scared that between, you know, dad's girlfriend just being all syrupy, honey, sweet and playing to those strengths, combined with the fact that now she's met whoever dude was who was gonna give her the mop, I just can see a potential seduction model happening here. And I predicted this last season that maybe Hope would show up there all gung-ho about the war and stuff in the beginning. But then, as she spent more time, gets comfortable with having all the amenities and the nice things, then maybe she's going to start thinking that, you know, maybe it's not so bad here. Like, maybe we had this place all wrong. Like, in the sense of, we still shouldn't fully trust them, but since we're doing good, maybe we should just hang out a little longer. You know what I'm saying? But even beyond that, even if it doesn't go to that point, the more people she starts to develop connections with within the CRM, the harder it's going to be for her to do what she needs to do, which is inevitably going to hurt some people because dad's girlfriend, we saw it, she's got the CRM tatted. Like, she's in it for life. You know what I'm saying? You don't tat your workplace or where you live on your body unless that stuff is deep for you. So she is definitely going to, I feel like she is going to definitely be willing to kill the father. She's willing to kill Hope, Iris, whoever she thinks might be in her way. I have no doubt that she probably will kill them if she thinks that's necessary in order for her greater good, or more, I should say, more specifically, to keep her experiments going. Oh, we did see at the end, though, that her dad has clearly picked up on the fact that she's answered a few questions about the whereabouts of her sister and Felix a little too assuredly. And so he's like, you're keeping something from me. What is it? So here's the dilemma. I don't know if it's a good decision for Hope to actually go through with this. I can definitely see potential for things going south if she tells her dad, just because I'm not sure how willing he's going to be. Like, to go against the CRM, I absolutely think he's willing to do that. I think he's always had his doubts about them, but it's that damn woman. It's that damn woman he's with. I do think he's in love with her, unfortunately, and I don't think he realizes that she is CRM for life and that she would absolutely sacrifice him and his family for the greater good. So that's where I feel like his Achilles heel is going to come in. And like I said, just something about the way they're framing up some shots and stuff with him in this episode, I have a sneaking suspicion he may not make it throughout this or out of this season, which would be sad for the girls. But hey, this is The Walking Dead. And then I guess on the other side of it with Hope, Iris, I should say, not much to say about that. I don't dislike Iris's character. She got a lot of hate last season, which I felt was pretty much unwarranted, but I am upset about this particular move. I think killing that officer was completely unnecessary. I ranted about it in the last episode, so I won't do it again, but we see it's creating more commotion. But really what I'm worried about is that she's just kind of like, I appreciate the drive she has for getting this revenge, and she's gonna have to get into a certain mindset if she's gonna go up against these people who are gonna be willing to kill her if necessary, but she's being reckless. And that's the part we need to like ixnay immediately, because the CRM is organized. They are not a bunch of chaotic, power-hungry, crazy people. They're a system that's been in place for a long time now. So they will systematically take you down. Like, she's talking all this big talk like, oh, see, we got over our tracks. It's all good. Look how we did that. No, sweetie. You got by because of other people having quick thinking of how to cover this up. But anyhow, I'll leave it alone. She's 17. She's just a kid. I don't expect her to know everything. But that was probably what annoyed me the most, is that hubris needs to be tempered. Hopefully that will happen before someone innocent gets hurt, but I feel like we're going to lose some people in that community, because we already saw Beardy, the guy with the white beard, he's totally going to rat them out. I can already sense it. He's going to rat them out because he does not like them being there. We finally saw Silas, one more member of our group, and we knew that he was taken by the CRM, and it looks like, I thought maybe they put him in jail or something, or they would imprison him, but I'm glad they didn't. Instead, they put him onto basically the worst job ever, in that he's got to clear the dead. And we didn't get to see much of him outside of just seeing that's his kind of his lot at the moment, and meeting this guy that we now know is Huck's boyfriend, or was Huck's boyfriend. She was gone for 2 years, so we'll see if that's going to be rekindled. This is where Silas is at the moment, but he at least now knows that the research facility, or that the headquarters of the CRM, are not far. He already knows. Does he know? Oh no, he assumes all the girls are there, right? Because when he would have parted from the group, it was when they were still on their way there. So he's going to think that they're all there right now, which is kind of, you can see that made him happy, because that's really who he wants to kind of rejoin with if possible, even though he knows that, actually no, he will want to rejoin with them, right? Because he knows now that he didn't kill that guy. So I think he kind of wants to get back, if for no other reason than to tell his little crush, Miss Iris, that he didn't actually kill nobody, so she doesn't have to hate him no more. So yeah, we kind of saw that. I feel like that's going to be, again, having more people within the CRM at some level versus outside is going to be advantageous. We're just not sure how yet. That was pretty much this episode. We're going to have to see how things go now that people are kind of getting involved in their groups. I am a little bit more intrigued of what's going on in the CRM right now versus what's going on with Iris, but I'm hoping that that's going to turn around here as maybe she starts to take a few breaths and realize that she cannot take on this entire military by herself, and that she's still got a lot of learning to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this episode along with me. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up, and we will see you in the next video.